Welcome to part 2 of the Atlas Copco ST Wrench tutorial series. In this video, we'll be using ToolsTalk BLM software to program some P-sets onto our ST wrench. Then we will perform some tests on our joint simulators here and check out our results and traces on the laptop. First, let's go over how to quickly install ToolsTalk BLM. Attach your ST wrench to the computer via USB and power it on. You may see it install some drivers automatically. Then, insert the installation CD into your computer and wait for the autoplay to launch. If it doesn't, you can navigate to the CD folder and right-click on the TTBLM Setup executable file and click Run as Administrator. Click Next on the first screen, then read the user agreement. You can print this for later reference. Click the button next to Accept, and you can proceed to the next step. Here you could enter your username and the organization you work at for licensing purposes. Click Next after you filled this in. Next, you could decide where to install the program to. I kept mine as the default location. Finally, it will ask you if you're ready to install, and once you click Install, it will begin the process. Afterwards, you can select Launch ToolsTalk BLM and Finish. The program will now launch and ask for your license and registration information, which you could find in the box that the software came in. My trial period has expired on this computer, as you can see. If you decide to try the software, you have 60 days before you have to register it. Now let's move on to setting up a P-set. First, we will open up ToolsTalk BLM on our computer. In the top right, we change our target device to ST Wrench. Confirm the change and wait for the software to open back up. Now we will turn on our ST Wrench and connect it via USB to our computer. Click the button up top that says Connect, and you should see your device now listed on the left. If you open up the P-set menu drop-down, you will see a list of all the existing P-sets that are saved on your device. We will create a new P-set either by right-clicking on the P-set in the menu or clicking the P-set button on the top bar. It will now ask you to assign a name and a number to your P-set. Now our P-set editor window pops open, and we can set the parameters for our tightening strategy. For this demo, I will be using torque control with angle monitoring with a goal of 25 Newton meters. Next, I will click on the torque tab and begin to enter my values for tightening. I'll start the cycle at 8 Newton meters, set the final torque minimum to 22 Newton meters, final target to 25 Newton meters, final torque maximum to 28 Newton meters. Make sure it's set to measure torque at peak, and set the change screw value to 30 Newton meters. For the angle information, I will set the start final angle at 8 degrees, with a minimum angle of 0 and a maximum of 200 degrees. I won't add any time restrictions, but I will increase the batch size to 3. Once ready, I will hit Store to save the P-set on the wrench. I can now disconnect the tool by hitting Disconnect up top and removing the USB from the wrench. On the wrench, I will navigate using the arrows to program mode. Then select P-set, and then select the P-set we just created. Next, I will attach my bit, and we are ready to perform some tightenings. As I begin to tighten the joint, the tracking won't kick in until I hit my cycle start torque of 8 Newton meters. Once I hit that mark, the tool begins to display my torque and angle progress. As I get closer to my goal, the tool light rings will light up, and the beeping will increase in speed. Once I am within my limit of my final torque, the tool will vibrate, letting me know to let off on the pressure. Right away, the low, high, or OK light will show on the tool and display on the screen as well. After completing all three tightenings for my batch, I get the batch OK status and the PSET will reset. I could back out of the PSET menu to the main screen again to review my results, but we want to see the traces as well. After connecting to the ST wrench again, with the USB, we can now click the results viewer and select our PSET that we want to see the results for. Here is our test. And you see that we passed all the requirements. Up top, we could also select the Trace tab to view our torque and angle traces on a graph. All of these results can be saved in multiple formats by clicking the Save icon up top and exporting the results to our hard drive. That concludes this tutorial. For more strategies, be sure to check out the next part of the ST Wrench tutorial series and leave a comment if you have any questions. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe to Flexible Assembly for more product tutorials and updates.